Welcome, and in this video I want to talk about AWS certifications. AWS have a full range of certifications at many levels and with multiple streams. Knowing where to start is often a challenge, and even when you have that first cert, knowing an efficient route through to your desired endpoint isn't trivial. So in this video, first I want to explain how to get started, then I want to talk about some common paths through the various certs, and finally I want to talk about the specialty certs and how their difficulty compares with everything else. Now that's a lot to cover, so let's jump in and get started. Now this is an overview of the current layout of the AWS certifications. It feels like every time I record one of these videos, a new cert is added, so we'll see how long this one lasts. You can look at AWS certifications as having four main difficulty levels, starting with the easiest, the practitioner level, then moving through associate, then professional, and finally to specialty. AWS have an official recommendation that most people start with the Cloud Practitioner certification. Now, this is marked as a foundational cert, which requires 6 months of AWS industry knowledge. Now, I disagree. For most people, I actually recommend against studying specifically for the Cloud Practitioner. To explain why, let's start off with one of my core beliefs. When you're looking to pass a certification, there are two components. First is the study, the part where you gain the knowledge which that cert requires. And this, in my view, is the valuable part, the part which lets you actually do a job working with AWS. Second is the actual taking of the exam and getting the official result. So these two things are different, and you need to treat them as such. Now, I'm a completist, and I'm not suggesting that you don't pass the Cloud Practitioner certification. I did, but for me, it was my 8th or 9th AWS certification, and I wanted it only so I could say that I had them all. What I'm suggesting is that you don't specifically study for the Cloud Practitioner. The reason is that with any good course, studying for the Associate Architect will give you all of the knowledge that you need to pass the Cloud Practitioner as well. And because there's a pretty big overlap, if you study for the Cloud Practitioner and then study for the Associate Architect, you're duplicating part of that study. Essentially, you're wasting time. Now, time is the only non-replaceable thing that we have, and so I'm pretty serious about being efficient with the usage of my time and my students. So my suggestion is that for almost everyone, even if you are new to cloud or new to AWS, that you start with the Solutions Architect Associate level of certification. Many of us who've been working with AWS for years and studying for certifications for just as long didn't have the option to start with the Cloud Practitioner certification. It wasn't available when I started studying, for example. So if you start with the Architect Associate, then it will teach you enough that you can either just take the Architect Associate exam or both that and the Cloud Practitioner. Now, I can't talk for every Solutions Architect Associate course on the market, but mine is designed so that you can take it with no pre-existing knowledge. I want students to save the time by not studying twice and save the cost for two different courses. More than that, though, the Solutions Architect Associate is a well-recognized certification, and because my courses teach the skills to work in that role, you increase your chances of a new job or a promotion by obtaining the Solutions Architect Associate versus the Cloud Practitioner. So whether you're new to cloud or AWS, or you have some experience, in 99% of cases, the Solutions Architect Associate is always the right area for you to start with. Think of it as the efficient entry point into AWS. Now, you might get other advice from friends or family or colleagues or even other instructors and even AWS. I'm not saying to ignore that advice, but I've worked in AWS for around a decade, maintained all of the AWS certifications and taught hundreds of thousands of students, and I can't recommend enough to start with the Solutions Architect Associate certification and initially ignore the practitioner. But what about after that? Well, that's a more interesting discussion. You can split AWS certifications into two main groupings. First, the role-based certifications, and these are designed around a certain job type. So they test a broader range of knowledge required to do a specific role, and this could be architectural, operational, or development in nature. Generally, these are the certifications which you tackle first. For 90% of people, these are the right ones to begin with. There are some exceptions, which I'll cover soon, but most people will have a far easier time doing the role-based certifications first. Second, you have the specialty certifications, and these are much narrower in terms of the knowledge requirements, but also much deeper. They're designed to prove that you have the deep skill required to be a specialist, and examples include a senior networking engineer and even an AWS data scientist. The specialty certs in most cases should be left until last. If you already have strong skills in one of the areas that are covered, you can consider doing them sooner, but generally there is a lot to learn in each of the specialty certifications, and they're much easier to tackle if you have the general knowledge that you're going to pick up while studying for the role-based certifications. Now, I want to try and show you this concept visually because I think it will help you conceptually understand how the various certs fit together. Now, on the left with the least amount of knowledge and skill requirements is the Cloud Practitioner. As a reminder, this is the one which I don't recommend studying for specifically. Next are the associate level certifications, and these contain the practitioner knowledge but layer on top of this additional associate specific requirements. So in terms of depth, the associate requires that you know more. Coverage wise, there aren't that many new topics introduced, it's just additional detail versus the cloud practitioner. At a professional level, this follows a similar pattern with one key difference. You'll start with a similar foundation, the practitioner and then the associate, but on top of this, the professional level requires more depth and more breadth. You'll need to know more about the same products which you covered at the associate level, but then also you'll need to know about more products, and this includes their architecture, features, and how to integrate them for projects. Then we have the specialties, and it's here where many students don't conceptually understand where the specialty certifications fit. Firstly, they're much technically deeper than the professional certs, but also they're narrower. If you're taking the advanced networking specialty, for example, then you don't need to have an awareness of the machine learning products, but you need a much deeper awareness of the networking products and features within AWS. Now, I like to think of the specialty certifications as having a 50-50 split between the specific specialty subject, say networking, and then the AWS skills. And the AWS skills need to be somewhere between an associate and a professional level. Now, I recommend that to make these doable, when starting to study for a professional cert, then you're either skilled in the specific area of that specialty certification, or you have AWS skills at a professional level. It's very rare that I would recommend anyone take a specialty cert until they have their solutions architect professional. I like to think of the solutions architect professional as a foundation for all of the specialties, in the same way that I think of the Solutions Architect Associate as a foundation for all the role-based certifications within AWS. Now, let's quickly finish up talking about the order of the certifications. There's no right answer when it comes to which order to tackle the AWS certifications. There are routes that people will recommend, traditional routes which they've taken through the various certifications, but in all honesty, anything is possible. It depends on your desired outcome and how much effort you're willing to put in. What I will say is this: you should 100% start at the associate associate level. I've mentioned a few times I'm not a fan of studying for the practitioner exam, and so in most cases I'd start by skipping the practitioner level. The associate level is where employers start taking notice, and in my opinion, it's also where it starts getting fun. Whatever your current job role, I would also recommend always starting with the Solutions Architect Associate. Architecture is at the core of everything else, and it also happens to be the easiest associate level certification. Starting with any of the others makes no sense. Even if you're a developer or work in operations, you'll end up studying less efficiently because both of the other associate certifications rely on architecture. Now, from an exam perspective, the format is multiple choice or multiple answer. You have a total of 130 minutes, and the cost is $150. Now, questions at the associate level tend to be between one line and 2 to 3 lines, and then you generally have 4 or 5 answers, each of 1 line each. So this is what to expect at the associate level. Once you have the associate architecture exam, then this is where you have a choice. Historically, the recommended route was to always do the developer associate next, and then follow this up with the SysOps associate. The developer associate isn't an exam which requires any development experience. Rather, it tests you on products and features that developers will use. In practice, this means the exam is very much like the Solutions Architect Associate, but with some extras like DynamoDB, SQS, Elastic Beanstalk, and much more. The overlap makes it pretty efficient to do the developer straight after the Solutions Architect. The Developer Associate exam format is similar in style to the Solutions Architect. The format is multiple choice and multiple answer. You have a total of 130 minutes, and the cost is $150. Now, the SysOps Associate is a similar story. It's the hardest of the associate exams, but it still has an overlap with the Solutions Architect Associate. Where the architect is about designing and integrating, the SysOps is about doing and fault finding. It's the same product scope in general, but with a much more operations focus, and so again, there are efficiencies that you can achieve by doing this straight after the Solutions Architect Associate. Now, if you decide on this route, at this point, you will have all of the associates, something which is known in the AWS certification community as all three. So that's option number one, and if you've taken option number one, the next step is to move to the professional level certifications. Now, these are much harder than the associates, and students can often fail because they underestimate just how much of a difference there is. Traditionally, you always did all three associates before attempting any of the professionals, and one of the things I wanted to achieve with my new courses is to allow students to do stream-based study. That is, to start with the Solutions Architect Associate and then move on to the Solutions Architect Professional. You'll still experience the jump in difficulty, that will always be the case, but I wanted to allow the path which avoids the need to do the developer and SysOps associate. You can still do those, but only if you want to. At a professional level, you need to prepare for the difficulty jump. The exams are longer, the questions tend to be 4 to 5 lines, there are 4 to 5 answers, and each of the answers ranges from 2 to 4 lines. This means that you need to read, understand, interpret, and select the right answer or answers, and do that consistently for 3 hours. It's 180 minutes, so only 50 more than the associate, but it will feel 10 times as long. It's a much more difficult exam. Now, the order to do the professional exams is also a point of contention with many AWS professionals and trainers. For me, it's an easy choice. Do the professional architect first, because architecture is at the core of everything. Even if you have skills and experience in the DevOps space, you'll still need a detailed understanding of AWS, and so do the Solutions Architect Professional first, and then you can finish up the professional tier with the DevOps Professional exam. Now, with both of these, there is overlap. When I was studying for them both, I allocated 3 months of study, studied the combined subject areas, and then sat the exams weeks apart. I wanted that efficiency. But at this point, if you follow the traditional route, you will have 5 certifications, 3 associate, 2 professional, and in the community, this is known as all 5. Now, I want to give you a moment to pause and just reiterate that the professional exams are really difficult. Don't think that the associates are a 3 out of 10 difficulty and the pros are a 5. If all of the AWS certifications are on a scale of 1 to 10 with the associates at a 3, then the pros are at a 10. I personally think that the professionals are harder than the specialty exams because of the breadth of knowledge that you'll require. The specialties in theory need deeper knowledge, but because of how narrowly focused they are, it's easier to really focus and retain the knowledge that you need. The professional exams are $300 US, and so they're much more expensive than the associate certifications, and this is another reason to give them the respect they deserve and make sure that you achieve that first time pass. Now, because I'm a completist, at this point I would probably loop back and pick up the practitioner certification if you haven't already, just to round off the role-based certifications. You don't have to, but I'm pretty obsessive, and for me, I had to get this completion. Not having just one cert was bothering me too much, so if that's you as well, go wild and complete all of the role-based certs by finishing up with the Cloud Practitioner. Now, at this point, my suggestions become very personal to your situation. The specialty exams can require significant effort, or they might be relatively easy if you already have advanced skills in that one specific area. They vary considerably in difficulty. The advanced networking is regarded as the hardest, and security or Alexa as the easiest. But it all depends on your skill level. The order depends on your skills. If you're a networking engineer, you might start with the advanced networking certification, though you might already have taken this based on what I discussed earlier. So if you already have skills in this one particular area, then potentially you could do certain specialties before you take the professional architect certification. It depends on your skills, so tackle them in order of how difficult you find the topics. The specialty exams are slightly shorter than the professionals, 170 minutes rather than 180, but they cost the same. Question and answer structure is similar to the professional levels, so all involve a lot of reading and understanding, but the questions test your much deeper understanding of skills in that one specific niche topic. Now, attached to this video, I've linked to the details of all of the current AWS certifications, and I'll keep this updated as any changes or additions are made to the lineup. You can see details of each certification within each of the exam overview documents, and where appropriate, I've linked to some sample questions which will give you an idea on complexity. It's also worth mentioning that the exams do also have practice tests which you can pay for, which have more examples of questions. Now, at this point, I hope this has been useful, but this is everything which I wanted to cover in this video. So go ahead and complete this video, and I hope to speak to you again in a future video.